There have been so many synchronicities today and lately that it's just not funny. Like the two new guys that just popped up at the same time are Matt and Jacob. And my son Matt went into the Job Corps, and the guy who let me use his phone the other day, his name is Jacob. And that's the dude who messaged me after, he used his phone after I had my experience, and both of these guys showed up in a week. Okay, that's one. That's a pretty big one. I was at Dollar General, and I was talking about my book, because I don't want to tell anyone that I believe that I'm God, but I'm hinting, and I'm saying funny things in funny ways. And the one lady happened to be there, and she started talking about, you know, God being in us and God being around us, and I made sure I asked her name, and I know her name is Robin. I didn't catch her last name, but I was like, okay, Robin. And she said, what's your name again? I was like, Dan Alexander. She's like, what was your name again? And I was like, Dan. I'm like, I didn't catch that, because that's just what they call me. That's just what they call me. I'm like, and just like you, that's what they call you, Robin. And she's like, I gotcha. And she looked at me and winked and then left. What the hell? That's crazy. And then she actually came back when I mentioned my book again, and she walked right in the door right after I said it. There's two sliding doors, and she wasn't even in the first sliding door yet. And she was, I just said, I'd done saying something to Pam, and she walked in the door and said, I'm going to be looking for that book. So I'm like, that's freaking awesome, man. And then, I mean, then some lady out of nowhere just said something, and I overheard her say, because another lady is like, I don't think they have any of those little red mints here. And I was like, oh, I being the bread guy, they do have red mints. And I overheard her just when I took my headphones out of my ear, which I wouldn't have heard her if I wouldn't take them out. And I was like, they're over here. So I went over and grabbed them. And then because I had that interaction, the other lady was in the line. They ended up passing each other. And the one lady said something about how beautiful it is outside. And I was thinking that already, so that's not that uncommon. And she's like, you know, I think the sun just sort of affects everybody. And I'm thinking to myself, are you kidding? Like, not only am I saying, are you kidding? Of course it does. It's you're from the sun. We're from the sun. But her just saying that out of nowhere, people are starting to feel it when they're around me. I haven't had one person get mad around me. They may have been angry before they saw me, but by the time they left around me, I've said the right thing. The only time that I've had any awkward moment was when I got over emotional and was getting too carried away. And the other time when I went to Walmart and they had new people there and people that are just in a really bad mood first thing in the morning. That's a hard time to break a frequency when people are tired in the morning. So, and I didn't know how to respond because it was them basically attacking me for telling me to do something and then telling me they didn't want it after I had already done it because I did what they wanted. So I was just trying to be defensive, but at the same time be like, listen, I mean, I'm not going to let you just yell at me when I did what you wanted me to, but I'm also not trying to be a jerk. So I said, you know, they actually told me to bring extra for homecoming last week. It just didn't sell. And I already cut some for next week. So by the time Monday comes, it'll all be taken care of. And like I said that really nicely, but then they were still worked up because, you know, I'm defending myself. So people seem to automatically get angry when you defend yourself, even if you're nice when you do it. Isn't that weird? I think so. Anyway, love you. Gotta go.